Welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to learn about the natural fibers, classification, preparatory process, properties, and uses. Fibers are the raw materials for all fabrics. Natural fibers have their origin from plants, animals, and minerals. For most of history, people had only natural fibers for making cloth. The use of natural fibers extends its history with archaeological evidence indicating that wool and flax were being woven into fabrics by 6th century BC. Classification. The natural fiber is the term covers a broad range of fibers obtained from natural sources such as plant, animal and mineral. Plant fibers. Plant fibers comprises of cellulose, for example cotton, jute, flax, linen, remi, sisal and hemp. Natural fibers can be further categorized into the following. 1. Seed fibers, collected from seeds or seed cases, for example cotton and kapak. Fruit fibers, collected from the fruit of plants, for example coir and betel nut fibers. Bast fibers are collected from the bast or skin surrounding the stem of the plant, for example jute, flax, remi and banana fibers. Leaf fibers are collected from the leaves, for example pineapple, sisal and agaves. The commonly used natural fibers are cotton, jute, flax, hemp, sisal and coir. Next is animal fibers. Animal fibers are commonly obtained from hair or fur of animals and generally comprise proteins. Silk fibers are extracted from the cocoon of the silkworm. Wool refers to the hair of the goat or sheep. Other animal fibers from camel hair and hair of the angora rabbit. Last category is mineral fibers. Mineral fibers are naturally occurring fiber or slightly modified fiber procured from minerals, for example asbestos fibers. Now we'll see the plant fibers. The first one is seed fiber, cotton. Cotton is of tropical origin but can also be cultivated successfully in temperate climate with well distributed rainfall. Cotton is a fiber that grows from the surface of seeds in the pods or balls of a bushy mallow plant. Each fiber is flat, twisted and ribbon like with a wide inner hollow with an elongated single cell composed of 90% cellulose, 6% moisture and the remainder consists of natural impurities. The protective wax like coating is present at the outer surface of the fiber. The basic parameters that judge the quality of cotton are the grade, the color, the length of the fibers and the character. Production process. The cotton is cleaned to separate dirt, seeds and short lengths from the cotton. Cleaned and de-seeded cotton is then compressed into bales, which permits economical storage and transportation of cotton. Cotton fibers are converted into yarns and then to fabric. Properties of cotton fiber. It has good strength, comfortable and soft hand, good absorbency, good color retention. It absorbs dye and print well, drapes well, easy to sew and handle, machine washable and dry cleanable. End uses. Cotton is used in apparel, home furnishing and industrial fabrics. Knit cotton t-shirts and cotton underwear are preferred for their absorbency and ease of care. Most sheets and pillowcases are blends of cotton and polyester, but 100% cotton sheets are also available. Second is fruit fiber, coir. Coconut fibers are extracted from the outer shell of a coconut fruit. It is called as coir fiber, which is coarser, thicker and durable fiber used for preparing many items from rope to floor mats. The fiber contains 46% of lignin and 44% of cellulose. The higher the lignin composition in fiber makes it stiffer. The fibers are extracted from both matured and immature coconuts. The quality of fiber depends upon their maturity. Brown fiber are from matured coconuts, which are thick, strong and have high abrasion resistance. White fibers are from immature coconuts, which are smoother and finer but also weaker. Fiber extraction. After removal of coconut with shell from coconut fruit, the outer part of coconut is used for fiber extraction. They are soaked for about 6 to 10 months depending upon the maturity of coconuts and water quality. They are either immersed completely or partially in water is called as retting. During retting, the soluble matter in coconut decomposes, thus helps in separation of fibers. After retting, the decomposed particles are removed either by beating the fiber with wooden boards or with mechanical decorticators. They are then washed and dried. The dried fibers are used for spinning. Properties. Both brown and white coir fibers consist of length ranging from 4 to 12 inches. Those that are at least 8 inches long are called bristle fibers. Short fibers which are also finer in texture are called mattress fiber. It has good strength and its diameter is 0.1 to 1.5 mm. Uses. Coir is used in rope, sacking, brushes, doormats, rugs, mattresses, insulation panels and packaging. It is also used in geotextiles, automobiles and agrotextiles. Third one, bast fibers, linen. Linen fibers are found just behind the bark in the multilayer stem of the flax plant. The fibers from the plant are separated from the woody stem and the inner pith is called as pectin. Production process. Flax plants with blue flowers yield the finest linen fibers. After about 90 days from seed planting, the leaves dry, the stem turns yellow and the seeds turn brown, indicating it is time to harvest the plant. The plants are often pulled out of the ground by hand, grasped just under the seed heads and gently tugged. The tapered ends of the stalk must be preserved so that a smooth yarn may be spun. These stalks are tied in bundles called beads and are ready for extraction of the flax fiber in the stalk. However, fairly efficient machines can pull the plants from the ground as well. The plant is passed through coarse combs which removes the seeds and leaves from the plant. This process called rippling is mechanized in many of the flax producing countries. The woody bark surrounding the flax fiber is decomposed by water or chemical retting, which loosens the pectin or gum that attaches the fiber to the stem. After the retting process, the flax plants are squeezed and allowed to dry out before they undergo the process called breaking. In order to crush the decomposed stalks, they are sent through fluted rollers which break up the stem and separate the exterior fibers from the bast that will be used to make linen. This process breaks the stalk into small pieces of bark called scythes. Then the scythes are scutched. The scutching machine removes the broken scythes with rotating paddles, finally releasing the flax fiber from stalk. The fibers are now combed and straightened in preparation for spinning. This separates the fiber from the longer and more luxurious linen fibers. Physical and chemical properties of flax. Flax is one of the strongest fibers. It is 2 to 3 times as strong as cotton and is second in strength next to silk. Linen has no significant elasticity. Linen is relatively stiff and has little resilience. Absorbency of linen is better than cotton. Flax has a silky luster due to the natural waxes found in the fiber. Flax has good resistance to sunlight. Linen scorches in flame in a manner similar to cotton. Linen has more body than cotton and drapes somewhat better. Dry linen has good resistance to mildew. It is more resistant to attack by insects and microorganisms. Linen is most suitable for summer apparel as it allows the heat of the body to escape. Linen launders well and gives up stains readily. Linen does not shrink a great deal. Linen, like cotton, is highly resistant to alkalis. Linen is damaged by hot dilute acids and cold concentrated acids. Linen does not have good affinity for dyes. However, it is possible to obtain dyed linen that has good color fastness. Acid perspiration will deteriorate linen. Alkali perspiration will not cause deterioration, but in either case, discoloration may occur. Uses: linen is used for apparels, home and commercial furnishing items, and industrial products. Bast fibers, jute. Jute is one of the cheapest natural fibers and is second only to cotton in amount of production and variety of uses. It falls into the bast fiber category. Cultivation: the plants are usually harvested after they flower, but before the flowers go to the seed. Retting: retting is the process of extracting fiber from the stem or bast of the bast fiber plants. The available retting processes are mechanical retting, chemical retting, dew retting, and water or microbial retting. After harvesting, the jute stalks are tied into bundles and submerged in soft running water. The stalk stays submerged in water for 20 days. However, the retting process may require less time if the quality of the jute is better. When the jute stalk is well retted, the stalk is grabbed in bundles and hit with a long wooden hammer to make the fiber loose from jute core. After loosening the fiber is washed with water and squeezed for dehydration. The extracted fibers are further washed with fresh water and allowed to dry on bamboo poles. Properties of jute: good quality jute is colored yellowish white and silver gray and has a lustrous appearance. The individual cells in jute are shorter than those of any of the other bast fibers. Jute is the weakest of cellulose fibers when dry and must therefore be spun into coarser yarns. The average strength of jute is about 3.5 gram per denier. Resiliency is poor and fabric do not return to shape after deformation without treatment such as washing and ironing. Jute has low sunlight resistance and poor color fastness. It is also brittle and subject to splitting and snagging. It is readily damaged by the action of weather, moisture, and abrasion. Jute cannot be bleached white since it disintegrates in strong bleachers. Hence, it is most often used in its natural color. Chemical finishes can be used to overcome the natural odor of jute and to make it softer. Jute is similar to other cellulosic fibers in its reactions to heat and chemicals. Uses: jute is the second most important vegetable after cotton, not only for cultivation but also for various uses. Jute is used to make cloth for wrapping bales of raw cotton and to make sacks and coarse cloth. The fibers are also woven into curtains, chair coverings, carpets, area rugs, hessian cloth, and backing for linoleum. Next is leaf fibers, pineapple. The fibers from the leaf of the pineapple frequently is labeled as pina. Matured pineapple leaves are used for fiber extraction. The fibers are extracted by either machine decortication or retting. After fiber extraction, they are washed and dried for further process. Properties and uses of pina. Most of the commercial fiber comes from the Philippines. It is between 5 to 10 centimeters in length and is lustrous and strong. The matured fiber is white and especially soft and lustrous. It is used for ship cables, power transmission cables and driving cables. Light colored fibers are spun into coarser yarn, which are used for clothes and bags. Fine fibers are used for making interior fabrics. It is also used for materials for summer hats, brushes and paper making materials. Second chapter is animal fibers, silk. Silk is also termed as the queen of fibers. Silk fiber constitutes of protein and can be woven into textiles. It is fine, strong and lustrous fiber composed of fibroin produced by the fibrous secretion of silkworms. Silk appears as a triangular like structure which makes the cloth lustrous by reflecting the light at different angles. Production process, sericulture. The cultivation of silkworm for the production of silk is termed as sericulture. Breeding silkworms. The breeding is carried out with the healthiest moth where the eggs are categorized, graded and tested for infection. The healthiest eggs are incubated and hatched usually in 7 days. They emerge as 3.2 mm long. They are maintained in a controlled environment. Breeding can occur normally 3 times per year. Feeding the larva. The larva feed on finely chopped mulberry leaves for every few hours for 20 to 35 days. The worms in this period are about 3.5 inches. They also shed their skin 4 times and change color from gray to pink color. Spinning the cocoon. The silkworm constructs a symmetrical wall around itself by tossing its head front and back. The insoluble protein like filament called fibrin and sericin, a soluble gum, is secreted from each of 2 glands called the spinneret, located under the jaws of the silkworm. The sericin hardens as soon as it is exposed to air. Thus results in bave, the raw silk fiber. The caterpillar spins a cocoon and safely transforms into the chrysalis in the pupa stage. Stowing the chrysalis. The chrysalis breaks through the protective cocoon and emerges as moth. Hence, the chrysalis must be destroyed by stowing so that it does not break the silk filament. The filature, sorting and softening the cocoons. The filature, the process of preparing silk thread from the cocoons, sorting under different characteristics such as color and size so that the finished product can be of uniform quality. The sorted cocoons are then softened by soaking in hot water to loosen the sericin. Reeling the filament. Reeling can be done manually or automatically. The cocoon is brushed to locate the end of the fiber, threaded through a porcelain eyelet, and the fiber is reeled onto a wheel. As each filament is nearly finished being reeled, a new fiber is twisted onto it, thereby forming one long continuous thread. Packaging the skeins. The raw silk filaments are reeled into skeins. These skeins are packaged into bundles weighing 5 to 10 pounds called books. The books are further packaged into bales of 133 pounds and transported to manufacturing centers. Forming silk yarn. Silk thread or yarn is formed by twisting the reeled silk. The skeins of raw silk are categorized and are soaked in warm water mixed with oil or soap to soften the sericin and then dried. As the silk filaments are reeled onto bobbin, they are twisted in a particular manner to achieve a certain texture of yarn. The silk yarn is put through rollers to make the width more uniform. The yarn is inspected, weighed, packaged and finally shipped to fabric manufacturers. Fiber properties. Silk has a triangular shaped cross section with rounded corners. Silk is a bright fiber with a natural shine. Silk fibers have poor covering power due to their thin filament form. Silk has a smooth, soft texture and not slippery. Mechanical properties: strongest of all the natural fibers and moderate to poor elasticity, moderate to wrinkle resistance. Chemical properties: it has a good moisture regain of 11%, a poor conductor of electricity, suitable for cool weather. Weakened if exposed to too much sunlight, attacked by insects, especially if left dirty. Yellowed by perspiration and dissolved in sulfuric acid. Induces: the silk fiber is used alone and in blends with other fibers for luxury apparels and household textiles. Some of the most expensive handmade oriental rugs are made of silk fibers. Very fine silk filaments are used in eye surgery. Silk sutures are still used by the surgeons. The protein fiber is believed to be more compatible with human tissues than sutures of other materials. Wool. Wool fiber is derived from sheep. It was probably the first animal fiber to be made onto cloth. The fibers consist of protein called keratin, covered by minute overlapping scales. Production process: the following are the major steps necessary to process wool from the sheep are: shearing, grading and sorting, cleaning and scouring, carding, spinning, weaving and finishing. Shearing: sheep are sheared usually in spring once a year. Most of the sheep are still sheared by hand. New technologies are also developed to use computers and sensitive robot controlled arms to do the clipping. Grading and sorting: grading is the breaking up of fleece based on overall quality, as high quality does not always mean high durability. Cleaning and scouring: raw or greased wool refers to the wool taken directly from the sheep, which contains dirt, sand, grease and dried sweat. To remove these contaminants, the wool is scoured in a series of alkaline bath containing water, soap and soda ash or a similar alkali. Then the wool is treated with oil to increase manageability. Properties: physical properties: wool fibers are weak, but wool fabrics are very durable. Flexibility of wool is excellent. Its resiliency is greatest when it is dry and lowest when it is wet. Poor conductor of heat, they permit the body to retain its normal temperature and are excellent for winter clothing. Wool can absorb about 20% of its weight in water without feeling damp. Dirt tend to adhere to wool fabric. Consequently, wool requires frequent dry cleaning or laundering if the fabric is washable. Wool becomes harsh at 100 degree and begin to decompose at slightly higher temperatures, weakened by prolonged exposure to sunlight. Chemical properties: mildew develops if left in a damp condition, quickly damaged by strong algalies. Hence, mild algae in warm or cold water can be used in scouring the raw wool fibers to remove greases. Damaged by hot sulfuric acid and not affected by other acids even when heated. It has high affinity for dyes, weakened by alkali perspiration, as it generally causes discoloration. It burns very slowly and it is self-extinguishing and is normally regarded as flame resistant. It has good press retention. It takes and holds creases well and is set by use of pressure, heat and moisture. End uses: suits, overcoats, dresses and underwear are commonly made from wool. In addition to clothing, wool has been used for felt, carpeting, insulation and upholstery. Next chapter is mineral fibers, asbestos. Asbestos is non-metallic and non-inflammable in nature. Asbestos fibers could be woven as fabrics for various uses like curtains for theaters, industrial uses, etc. Since it is a flame-resistant fiber, it can be used in the manufacture of safety clothing for firefighters and insulation products like hot water piping. Manufacturing. The first step begins with fiberizing asbestos and freeing it from rock impurities. The fibers are then carded into a sheet and then separated into rovings, which are wound on jack spools and spun into yarn. Yarn can be made into thread, cord or rope. Metallic yarns are made by adding strands of fine brass, copper or lead wire to the strands of asbestos. The yarns can be woven into fabrics. Crude fiber is generally prepared for spinning at the factory where it is to be spun. Preliminary treatment of fiber is usually accomplished in a pan crusher. Crude fiber is fed into the pan and scrapers push the fiber under the rotating wheel. This operation is very critical since it can mechanically break the fibers. Special techniques and such engineered rolls as rotary tooth cylinders have been devised to reduce damage of fibers. After crushing, the fibers are transferred to opening devices which actually fiberize the product further. The open fibers pass over shaking screens or through trommel screens where they are again cleaned. Final operation generally involves lifting of suitable asbestos fibers by air suction. Blending of such fibers as asbestos with cotton can be performed in a preliminary mixing operation prior to the carding operation. However, the blending is generally performed during the carding operation. Carding rolls are fitted with a series of sharp steel bristles, rotating brushes which comb the fibers into specific positions. During this combining operation, short fibers and minute contaminating products such as rocks are removed. The result of carding is that opened asbestos fiber is formed into a loose continuous sheet or blanket. Properties: it is resistant to microorganisms or insects. It is resistant to heat, burning and chemical attack. It possesses high tensile strength, low electrical conductivity, and it is flexible enough to aid spinning. Uses: asbestos is used in insulation, building construction materials, textiles, missile and jet parts, and in friction products such as brake linings. Let us conclude this chapter with the following points. This content will be helpful to know about the natural fibers, their origin, properties and uses. Thank you for listening.